This is an engine lathe which is very common to most machine shops. It got its name because during the Industrial Revolution there would have been an external engine outside of a building with shafts running through the ceiling and belts running down to the equipment. It typically is used for making cylindrical parts, and jobs done on a lathe are called turning. There are five main parts to the engine lathe: the headstock, which is found up here, the quick change gearbox, which is below it, the bed, the carriage, and finally the tailstock. The first major part of the lathe, the headstock, has a box on top of the lathe, and if we were to take this cover off you would see the gears inside it. Here are shifter levers. This one's a high and a low range, and this one here will set the different RPM selections according to this chart. These levers will be unique to the manufacturer and may look different. In other words, some may have a dial on it, some may have different types of levers, things like that. A little further down in the headstock, this is the feed reverse lever. This controls the feed moving either towards the chuck, away from the chuck, or towards center, or away from the center. This is the spindle nose, and there's a spindle that runs right through the lathe, and it's hollow. And on the end of the spindle nose we have a work holding device. In this case it's a four jaw chuck. The speed will be set in revolutions per minute, or RPM. This lathe actually has an attachment up on top of the headstock which is a digital readout, which is a really nice feature to have. Having a closer look at the spindle, there's a hollow tube that runs right through the headstock of the lathe. On the end of it, it will have a taper, a Morse taper, to hold other type of tooling. On the outside there's also a taper. This taper is meant to align the work holding device, in this case it's a chuck. If we have a look at the back of the chuck on this one, you can see a cam lock system which bolts onto the end of the spindle nose. This is probably the most common one you're likely to find in industry. Others will be the taper and key. So this one actually sits on a taper and it is driven by a key, and then it is threaded onto this collar, and you can see the thread on the back of the chuck here. The last one is the threaded spindle nose, and this one here is meant to screw onto the chuck. This is great if the work is revolving past the cutting tool. As soon as you turn it in the other direction, reverse, you need to be really careful that this spindle doesn't back off this chuck. This is the back of the lathe between the headstock and the quick change gearbox. You can see the spindle that comes through the headstock. We have an electric motor in this case here which is running a pulley which goes into the headstock, causing the gears to turn in that. We have a gear that's coming out of the headstock and down through the back gears, and there's a ratio between these gears. Some lathes will require you to change these gears for different threading applications, and this gear is actually going into the quick change gearbox. Again, this is found in the back of the lathe. On the left hand side of the lathe, directly below the headstock, is found the quick change gearbox. This particular manufacturer has several different shifter levers, and again it'll be unique to the manufacturer, and you'll set the letters and the numbers in order to get the threads per inch for threading, or the pitch for metric threading, or the feed rate. It'll either be in inches per revolution of the spindle or millimeters per revolution of the spindle. The chart up here will help set that. There are gears in the back of the lathe that transmits the power from the headstock down to the quick change gearbox, and then it comes out these rods here. So this is a lead screw, and when it's turning you are using it for threading, and then there's a feed rod directly below it, and this is used for feeding, again in inches per revolution or millimeters per revolution of the spindle. Attached to the quick change gearbox below the headstock of the lathe is the bed, and this is a heavy casting that goes from the left hand side of the lathe to the right hand side. On top of this bed is a set of ways, and these are ground and hardened surfaces that allow other parts to slide on. Below it we have a rack and pinion which allows us to move the carriage back and forth along it. With the bed you want a really heavy casting to add support for the lathe and give it rigidity. In other words, it's considered the backbone of the lathe. Sliding along the ways of the bed is the carriage, and it has a lot of things going on. It has three main parts. This is the apron which holds most of the controls. On top of it, there's an 8-shaped casting which slides along the ways, and this is called the saddle. On top of the saddle, there's also another slide which is called the cross slide. If we have a look on the front of the apron, this hand wheel here is the longitudinal hand wheel, which allows you to move the carriage towards the headstock and away from the headstock manually. This handle here is the cross slide hand wheel, allowing you to move the cross slide in or out manually. And both of these typically will have a graduated collar on them, so you can set zero on it. There's a little lever here, and this is a plunger type of lever, and if it's pushed in or pulled out, it will allow you to move the lathe either towards center through the cross slide or back and forth along the ways, longitudinal slide, at a controlled feed rate set in the quick change gearbox. This here is the feed engage lever, which allows you to engage the feed once the feed direction is set through the feed directional lever. If we look a little further down the apron, this is the half nut control lever. So when we're threading, we will push this down, engaging the half nut, which will engage the lead screw and allow you to cut a thread. And that's what's going on here. This is for threading. This is a little dial that turns when the lead screw is turning. Again, if we have a look on the top on the saddle here, you can see the cross slide, which moves in towards center and away from center. And on top of the cross slide, we have the compound slide, which allows you to manually set the cutting tool in towards the workpiece or away from it. And this will swivel up to 360 degrees, allowing you to set it to whatever angle you need to. And if you look up here, on top of the compound rest is the tool post. In this case, it's a quick change tool post. The last major part of the lathe is the tailstock, and there's actually a two-piece casting. The bottom of the casting actually bolts to the ways through a lever that is actually hidden just in behind the back. This is the pivot point of that lever. And the top part of the casting actually can be moved towards the operator or away from the operator. So you could cut a taper with this tailstock if you wanted to. Out the end here is a spindle, which is moved in and out by the hand wheel down at the far end. And inside the spindle is a taper, a Morse taper. It's meant to hold drill bits, reamers, centers, things like that. There actually is a scale often on the outside of it in inches and in millimeters, so you can tell the depth of the tool coming from the inside of the tailstock. This lever here actually locks the spindle into place so it won't retract or extend when in operation. Down the far end, we actually have a graduated collar, so we could set zero on it. And again, this hand wheel is meant to feed the cutting tool out or back in, or the center, whichever you have in the spindle.